Trollord Games. Join the fray.
Hello, wherever and whenever you are, and welcome back to Phoenix Iwaki, and welcome back to the Valley of Barovia, as we return to Barovia and beyond. Now, a massive hey hello to everyone, Thamiar and Phantom, and who else are we kicking around? Rubblejax, hello, welcome in everybody, hope you're doing well, and it's nice to have you here. We are happy to be here, and we are happy to be brought to you at the moment, as you may have noticed in the intro there, a little extra going on, as at the moment we are being sponsored by the fabulous Trollord Games over in the far corner there. You should head on over, as I know some of you have already, you should head on over to this Kickstarter right here. The smoldering remnants of evil lie within the shattered ruins of Alfstrag, where the undying war is born again. That is live right now, a D&D 5th edition adventure path, which goes from level 1 to level 13. There's all sorts of local politics and monsters and extra planar stuff going on. Beautiful maps, beautiful art, and a very nicely written adventure to boot. You definitely should head over there if you have not already and back that project, and you can enjoy this fantastic adventure with your friends too. Now, if you would like a sneak peek without getting anything spoiled for you, you should join us tomorrow. As I'm going to turn the music down a bit, sorry, it's a bit noisy. You should join us tomorrow as we are running a very special one-shot set in the setting of the Undying War Kickstarter, and we're going to be introducing some of the locales and the NPCs and a bit of the ambiance that is going there. I know there is a satyr on the way from one of our good friends there, and you can see the fabulous crew that we have set up ready for this one shot. The wonderful Dead Aussie Gamer, Dreaded GM AJ Winters, and Kendall from One For All, a fantastic group who will be delving into this adventure. And I hope that you are able to join us too. And if you do, then there is the chance to get yourselves all sorts of loot from said troll lord. And, you know, if it's a lord, they've always got the best loot. So you can head on over there, and there are going to be several copies of physical books that we can be sending your direction tomorrow. And also a very special prize of a signed copy of the adventure itself once it is finished and ready to ship out. So do not miss the chance to do that. And if you're looking for loot a bit closer to the date that we are at right now, we do have our giveaway going on today as well. If you would like the chance to win a free piece of fabulousness from Trollord Games, please jump into the giveaway, !enter for your chance to win, and that will give you a code to get any single product on the Trollord Games catalogue. Not the bundles or anything like that, but any of the single products there you can grab for free, and not just giving away a single thing today, you can choose which one would be best for you. They have lots of D&D stuff, of course, and they have a lot of stuff for their own amazing Castles and Crusades game, a wonderful system that is something that we are looking forward to trying out here on our channel in the near future. So please do jump into that giveaway, and best of luck for that. I know that Rubblejax has already got themselves some of that loot, but don't worry, the Troll Lord's loot pile is very large, and there are still plenty of things to be grabbed by bold adventurers. Now, as we are diving on in here, let me also say a thank you to Nethrex3D, the wonderful folks over there. Hey, good luck, guys. The wonderful folks over there have given us a nifty little code for you to get a nice discount over on their beautiful 3D printed minis. Head on over there to their Etsy and have a look at all their stuff going on there. Beautiful stuff there. And, of course, Sirenscape. Thank you for the beautiful sounds and music. Sirenscape.com for a free trial, everybody. Right. Now, last time we... No worries, Papa, we're just in the intro, mate. Last time we were here in Barovia, a pitched battle was raging within the mountainside as our adventurers had snuck into the werewolf's lair wherein hid the airwolves, the lycanthrope Aarakocra, the various natural wolves and other regular looking werewolves, but all of them led by the fearsome Lu Garu, the leader of the pack, who came in on his motorcycle. Yes, you people say. And they managed to very cleverly use their magic. Our poor little Mapak friend, who is not feeling too well today, send your love and healing vibes in Mason's direction, everybody, down to Florida. They used their...
Florida man, Mason. Florida man misses D&D because of fever.
I think they would take liberties there. It's like, Florida man misses D&D because of swamp fever.
Florida man misses actual dungeons because of actual dragons.
Quite possibly. I wouldn't put it past them. Now,
yeah, that's what they call gators down there.
And they, they use their magic to seal off parts of the cavern and isolate the fearsome Lu Garu, this larger than normal, more powerful than normal, legendary action-toting lycanthrope. But it was not enough. Actually, it was worse than that, because it was one of his legendary actions that he used to impale himself
on... Oh, that's
what a way to go.
On said Mapak's magic.
Yeah.
Sucks to suck, my guy.
Amen, Clarence. Welcome. There was a pitched battle against the creatures, but they were successful. And those that were on their side, Zulika particularly, was able to face down the old alpha male's mate, Bianca, and take control of the pack. And it is as we rejoin you fine folks in the cave here that she is striding out towards the front of the cave to call off those that are battling against the Vistani out on the snows of the southern mountains of the Vale of Barovia. So, as we return to this scene, as we return to this situation, let us meet these fine people. Esmeralda, who are you in real life? Who are you playing, and where are they at?
Yes, hello. I am Marin, and I am playing Esmeralda Devonier, the Blazing Vistani Battlemaster. Where are we at? We are doing good. We managed to, well, I didn't personally, but we, as a team, managed to kill the Lugahu who killed me. So that's been pretty good. I'm feeling like my quest for vengeance has been
completed. Did you die?
Yeah, that's why I'm currently reborn.
She's reborn. Yes.
Oh, I thought you meant like in the last battle, you like dropped to zero HP. Yeah,
How long has it been in game? It's been a couple of weeks since I died.
Yeah, it's been a while, yeah.
It's only been a couple weeks in game.
I've been very focused on
in real life a long time.
This is great.
Yeah. Wow.
It's been a while. Still don't know all the implications of what happened there. I'm slightly concerned. Anyways, we're doing good. We're very happy to have that particular knot tied up, as it were.
Indeed. And all squared away. Mm-hmm. And Bjorn, who are you in real life? Who are you playing and where are they at, mate?
Hello, I'm Shez. Shez Lens in the chat and all socials. I'm playing Bjorn Hardborn, Werebear Shifter, Beast Tide Paladin. Bjorn's just realizing that convoluted plan that we made two sessions ago with the hold person and the charm person and the suggestion, none of that came to fruition because we just, jumped this guy because he noticed us before he had his chat with his wife. Could have saved his spell slot. We both could have saved spell slots.
True.
It was cool, right?
Yeah, it was cool.
It was a good idea. Good to have contingencies.
Yeah, that's
exactly.
D&D for a
good
fact.
Plan,
it's like you make a plan and then you end up just fist fighting God.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, I'm psyched to... I can't wait to get this creepy doll into normal human form again.
Yeah.
That's a plot point that we didn't... But, like, I forget about all the times. Oh, also, we have to fight a samurai,
fine.
A mummy,
she's
our
fine.
Dark selves, and also fix this creepy doll.
So creepy.
Yeah.
I cannot wait to burn it.
Yeah, I can't wait. Yeah. Also, there might be a Tarrasque romance in my future. Who knows?
Yes.
Might be.
We're getting four.
Remind me, Shiz, what was the monetary amount you put on romancing a Tarrasque?
I said if we hit 6,000, I would try and romance a Tarrasque.
$6,000, you say? That seems like an inordinate amount of money that we would never possibly reach. How did
we reach it during our stream.
How did we end up at the end of the campaign?
I think it was, like 10,000 something.
$10,300, indeed. Yes, absolutely incredible. Thank you so much, everyone who was with us last week and able to support that amazing cause. And hats off to everyone over at the Games Tavern for such an amazing event. All the good that they've done. And there is...
No more hungry kids.
Something... on the DM's Guild that goes by the name of Invasion from the Planet of Tarrasque.
Oh, great.
As written, it happens in Waterdeep. But this particular Tarrasque invasion force may be taking a little detour through the mists, a little scenic route, if you will. And, folks, if you're not already, give us a follow to get into the followers Discord, and you can hear the news of when that is going to happen. Our Barovia and Beyond players will be trying to deal with invading Tarrasques as they come charging into Barovia.
At some point on our way to...
charisma. Just saying.
At some point on our way to Fantasy Japan... we have to run into Tarrasques. Wait, sorry. Are we pluralizing Tarrasque? Is it more than one Tarrasque?
Did I?
How many can you handle, Bjorn?
Well, the question is, only one of them's into you, Bjorn. So you have to figure out.
Yeah,
which one
it is. I mean, like Bjorn's Pan and Polly. So like, you know, like he's down for like whatever and however many. But like, holy shit, man. I do have a. My charisma saving throw is plus 11, but my normal charm is not great. That was a plus 7 of persuasion.
On, like, woodland features.
Yeah.
Just find a squirrel and be like, hello.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes.
I don't know. I think against a Tarrasque, an attempt to charm is a saving throw, always.
Yeah, okay, good. Can a paladin stalk charm person? Wait, is Tarrasque a person? Uh-oh.
Hashtag Tarrasque lives. Wait.
Tarrasques are people too.
Oh, if I'm romancing them, they are.
Okay, now, everyone, Bjorn alluded to the facts just before, but yes, they did receive knowledge and visions whilst in the Amber Temple. Up here in the mountains, sudden music stop is sudden. Sorry, everybody. As they were researching what to do and how to reinstate the Ladies of the Thanes, the Fae goddesses that once held sway here, and if they are to be successful, what would they need to do? Well, they have discovered that the spirits of the Ladies of the Thanes are being held imprisoned in other parts of Ravenloft, other domains of dread, and they found that they need to find and deal with guardians here in Barovia. For those guardians are holding on to what is known as a mist. Hang on, is it? Am I getting right? Mist key? No, that's not right. Oh, what's that called? A mist talisman? Why am I forgetting the word? Sorry, excuse me, everybody.
Is that the thing that like snapped in half in Japan like recently?
No.
Okay, cool.
No, it's the item that guides you through the mists without getting lost and dying, basically. So, mist. I think it's called a mist talisman.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, anyway, you know what I mean.
That's what it is.
They received...
Don't correct us, correct the wiki.
they received visions of these various talismans and those that were guarding them, as Bjorn mentioned. And what are they to do? How are they to do this? And will it be with their drow friend Asara or not?
Is she the one in the creepy doll?
She is.
Yep.
The doll one, yes. Her natural body being used by the spirit of the doll, having stolen it away through cursed magic from this evil toy, and now puppeteering it throughout Barovia. Shout out to Perception Studio, thanks for the felted friends on Saturday. And check out our clips on the channel, guys. There's some amazing ones from Saturday. And you need to find out what has happened to Asara's body, guided and Jaegered as it is at the moment by this evil toy, so that you can create the situation and perform the ritual to return her spirit to its proper housing. And now that the Lugaru is dead, if that is able to be done, then you will be able to remove the lycanthropy from her as well. So.
Good, I fucking hate werewolves.
That's...
All the movies are about werewolves. Where's the werebear movie? What about werebear in American London? Or, you know, what they have to play basketball. Werebears.
Okay, folks.
Teen bear.
You make your way down through the caverns. The various wolves and werewolves still kind of growling, and they've got their hackles up, but Zulika just curls a lip at them, and they kind of like look back down, and you feel the biting wind and snow blowing in through the very on point wolf head cave entrance as you make your way out towards there. And
so tacky, these werewolves.
Zulika actually starts picking up pace. She's like, boom, boom, boom. She goes running out, and as she does so, she changes into her hybrid form, and you hear her just howl and speak in the language of the lycanthropes and call off the rest of the pack. And you can hear jeers and shouts from the Vistani as the wolves retreat. And you emerge on the side of the mountain with the snow whistling and blowing about. And you see down below the mountainside, where the path, the road comes from the junction towards the Amber Temple, you see the familiar sight of several barrel-topped wagons. And a defensive cordon around those wagons, as Esmeralda, you see a familiar hunched figure wrapped up warm on one of the front benches of the wagons. And they are being very well protected. And between here and there, there is a rather grisly sight. Probably equal parts dead Vistani and werewolves and wolves alike. But there are still a great deal of Vistani alive as well.
I thought I was the only grisly sight around here.
Zulika.
I'm going to hell.
Does Zulika need to try and pull rank on you as well?
Probably bring the children with us. I don't just want to leave them in the cave.
Let's fucking get out of this wolf hole.
With the kids.
This literal den of wolves.
Now, back at Argon Vostholt, your base of operations, there are other children with lycanthropy, so you can play together.
Exactly. Play date.
Yeah.
But we'll need to, make sure they aren't in cages and can come with us.
Indeed.
So, I'm assuming we'll bring them out with us as we come out to meet the Stani?
Zulika was more interested in stopping the slaughter as quickly as possible. So before anyone else was killed.
Right.
And I haven't seen the film, but I've seen some very funny reviewers that I like talking about it. I think it was very much like that Twilight battle where they're just twisting heads off people. It's like, just going at it. Martin Shaw just having a good old time realizing it's a horrible movie, but he's going to have a good time with it anyway.
And it was all a vision. It was only all just a vision.
Spoilers. Spoilers.
Oh, shit. I mean, who knows? Maybe, you know, oh my god, real fights. Yeah. A very serious movie that you don't want to get spoiled. Yeah.
Heaven forbid. As soon as it's done, Zuleika does disappear back in sight. And Esmeralda, do you head down to Madame Eva?
I head back to the children first. I don't want to just leave them there, not knowing what's going on. Well,
Zuleika's gone together, that's what I said.
Oh, she's gone together, in that case, yes. Yeah.
So, like, should we go talk to Eva?
Yeah.
Alright, let's do it.
Okay, so yeah, you kind of half slide, half, you know, jump down the mountainside towards the road, and Madame Eva stands up and is helped down onto the surface of the road and disappears for a moment because she's just surrounded by these tall, tall Vistani. She's somewhere in the back there. And as you approach, they do part, and you see with shawls with all sorts of little snippets of, you know, little shards of mirror like woven into them, and beads clicking and clacking in the strong mountain wind here. She's like, it is so nice to get the fresh air in the lungs, although my powers are a little fraught here, so close to the mists. And she reaches out one gnarled hand, and you can just see the wall of mist just beyond the werewolf's cavern. I do not believe we've had the pleasure, well, face to face, at least. I have met you many times in the cards, fated one. To you, Bjorn, she says.
Me? Look, I don't play many cards, so, you know, I don't know what cards you might have met me in, but cool, nice to meet you in cards too, I guess.
You have...
You would have seen me use cards similar to hers, actually, in the last battle.
You have never had your tarot card reader?
Wait, Maren, what was that?
Oh, you would have seen me use some strange-looking cards during the last battle. So
yeah.
You perhaps enjoyed that.
Well, I don't do much reading, books or cards or otherwise, but Maren has some cool cards.
Maren has some cool cards.
But Esmeralda has some cool cards.
Another ally?
Eva, Madame Eva, kind of like hobbles over slowly, and you kind of both look at her expectantly, and she just slowly reaches up for Esmeralda. And do you kind of like bow down to her, towards her?
Yeah.
Okay. And she raps you smartly on the head. Why have you not given him a reading? What are you doing, Esmeralda?
We've been a little busy. There's quite a lot that's happened since I last saw you. But you're right, perhaps. I didn't think to ask him.
In the last 4 days, we've had to, like, dodge fireballs, romance a lich, have platonic relationship with Lich, read books.
You see,
have eyes melt out of head.
You see, Bjorn, if only you had come to me, then I could have saved you so much trouble. Love was never on the cards for you and that wizened old fool.
I think I might as well be trying to romance a dinosaur.
Well, I
looks wistfully into the stars.
I have seen some rather disturbing murmurings in the cards. Something almost apocalyptic.
Is there a spooky guy with a sword?
And fear is on our horizon.
Like, for me specifically, like, I have to
stop
it or start it?
I wish I was already prepared to run it, because that would be the perfect time for just the sky to just tear.
The sky just turned red. A meteor crashes into the outside. Dinosaurs are coming up. I'm just like, you said no romance. Watch me. With no spell slots and a quarter of my HP.
Ding dong, Bjorn. Fate is calling. Fate is calling.
Aren't Tarrasque like level 20? Should we level up 10 levels before I try and romance one?
Okay. Your charm.
Yeah, right.
They're, you know, the protective sort.
Yeah.
Everyone, make sure you don't miss that session, everybody.
Yeah, I'm not sure when it's gonna be, but it's gonna be a joke. It's gonna be it's gonna be canon, I think, right?
Yeah. Yeah. There is a canonical honey heist in this realm, so yeah. Yeah, it's all good.
Multiverse.
Oh yeah. My my Deadlands cowboy from New Orleans appeared in Rhyme of the Frostmaiden.
Oh, really?
On Tuesday. So yeah, it is all interconnected. And speaking of connections, Intense Quack comes raiding on by. Good to see you again, my friend. Welcome in, everybody.
That's a great name.
Intense. How you doing, everyone? Welcome in. I hope you had a fantastic, fantastic session. Let me do a little shouty-outy here. Intense Quack. Boom. Was it some D&D? It was. Excellent. I hope you had a fantastic session, everyone. Welcome in, raiders. You have come raiding by before, and thank you very much, as always. Right, Mooncloud, we loved our honey heist here. It was in Valaki, so it was like a Barovian honey heist. It was insane.
It was a new campaign. Of course, it's going to TPK.
Oh,
I hope it was a session zero, man.
So you came to Barovia to get cheered up. Am I getting this right?
Yeah. I mean, this is the Barovia comedy hour, so you're okay.
What's the deal with dinosaurs?
we are just reveling in the successful fight against a Lugaru, vicious werewolf lord. And the fight against childhood hunger in the US, as we had a fantastic charity thing last week. One of the results of which is that invasion from the planet of Tarrasque is going to happen in Barovia in the near future. So please do join us. It's going to be a good old time. Now, everyone, raiders, we do have a giveaway on the go at the moment. These wonderful people at Trolllord Games are giving away a coupon to get any single product from their catalogue that you desire. Exclamation mark enter to jump in there. Please jump on in if you want to get some cool stuff for your games, be it Castles and Crusades or D&D or anything you'd like. And also, please, if you have not already, check out their fantastic Kickstarter that's going on at the moment. And don't miss the sneak peek one-shot we're doing tomorrow with some very special guests.
It was around 10k, Aaron Dragonborn.
Yeah, 10,350, I think.
USD, baby.
US dollars, indeed. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I said it to a couple of students that, you know, we had talked about it. We talked about it last week, and they were asking how it had gone, and they like kind of look, they're like trying to do the maths in their head, like that woman.
How much is that
the
yen?
One of the things, yeah. It's like, could you say that in yen? And I do, and they're like, whoa, okay. So yeah, thank you so much, everyone. Amazing. Okay.
Heck the NHK. Heck him to death.
No get hungry, everybody. If that's supposed to be.
Oh my god! I thought they meant the people who knock on our doors and asking us if we have a TV. If you don't live in Japan, that is an actual thing that may happen to you.
Not the Japanese BBC.
Yeah. The Japan Broadcasting Company. I think like whatever NHK stands for, they'll just like come around and be like, hey. Yes. They'll just come around being like, hey, do you like have a TV? And if so, do you get our channel? Because you should pay us. And the correct response is, I've never heard of TV.
Indeed. Okay, so Madam Aver looks up at you shrewdly, Esmeralda, through squinted eyes. And she's like, so, what is on the cards now? Where will you be headed?
Well, first I think somewhere to rest.
Hope it's not to see those.
Not our best.
Not to see those hacks in Valaki, I hope.
Wherever
I
there is bad, I will
You've
be
got
going.
Some long lost children to. Actually, Marin forgets. Were some of these children Vistani children that were supposed to recover, or is it?
Nope, they were from Daggerford, you know, through in on the Sword Coast.
Okay. So we have some extra children.
They wouldn't dare steal any of his tiny kids.
Okay. I figured it was like, supposed to make sure. I actually haven't done a Taroka reading, have I?
Nope.
Like, do you need, like, the time and date of my birth? Is it, you know, like, my rising sign and my setting sign?
Yes. In which house is your son? I don't know. Astrology.
Esmeralda, she kind of winces. She's like, well, unless you want to lose your deck, I would not recommend doing it here. Shawl that whips about her face.
I mean, I didn't mean to do it, like, here. But yes, I think we've perhaps at least to get out of the wind and do some planning.
You can go back to Bjorn's boyfriend's place. It's not so windy in the Amber Temple.
Look, we're just friends now, dude. Be chill, man. He hasn't looked me in the eye since they melted off my face.
She side-eyes one of the Vistani nearby. He's like, what did I tell you? Besotted.
Now. All right, let's go take these kids to the haunted Lich King's house.
Yes, do that. I need to have a discussion with our new pack leader. If things are to be a little more friendly from now on.
They will be, I hope.
Indeed. I need to, I think I need to bring them together with our friends at the Wizard of Wines. Extol the virtues of passing on lycanthropy to those who wish it.
Perhaps the world was slightly better.
It's strange. You should see some of the people in the village, in Valachia and Barovia. All the young folks, they're itching to be white werewolves.
Really?
Yes. There is a shop in Valachy that recently opened. It sells nothing but jorts. It's quite crazy.
So many jorts. You know where bears can wear jorts too. It's not just wolves. You know, I've got jorts underneath this plate mail.
I'm sure you have, dear. I'm sure you have.
And they're not those fake jorts that are pre-jorted. I ripped the legs off myself. I hate when you go to a jeans store and they've got pre-jorted jeans.
Like,
you see these leg muscles? They pop out of jeans. That's why they jorted.
Yes, I hear the first transformation can be quite an experience. Apologies and sympathies to your wardrobe. Now.
Yeah, wolves are small too. Bears are fucking massive.
She looks up and continues to look up. He's like, yes, evidently.
Oh, sorry. And I do those too, Mosquart.
You know, there are some friends of yours, well, like-minded individuals, hanging out with a much snowier version of one of your folk there, Bjorn. I think you'd get on swimmingly. I mean, you should travel there if you ever escape this place.
I can't wait to see it.
Come in snowy versions.
If we ever leave this place.
Hey, well, if we do, we'll unleash a Lich King into the mortal plane. So, you know, there's that.
You probably shouldn't spread that too widely, just saying, especially not here.
Look, the more people that know about it, the better, because we're not going to be able to take care of it.
I wouldn't worry about it too much. There's all sorts of powerful individuals in the material plane. My friends.
I love that we're backdoor piloting another campaign for the Yuakiverse.
Esmeralda, you've talked about it often. The people you met on your travels.
Do I remember?
Out of character. Yeah, I lost. Tell us what's happening.
Yeah, when you began.
No, I lost my memory.
Okay.
There's a faint recollection, but not. You can't pinpoint it very well. Mm. No, look. Please, do your best. All of these people deserve their freedoms. We Vistani feel that keenly at the moment, as we had them and then were taken away. There are people on the material plane that can deal with Exthanta, if needs be.
And they're
stronger on their home turf. And she kind of looks to the north, beyond, like, towards where your parents live.
Mm. Yeah.
They do not do so well around these parts.
Well, maybe when these parts aren't in these parts anymore, we'll be finally feeling better.
Marin nods in chivalry.
Working on it.
Let's get this realm out of here.
I'm actually Marin, Chuck from Troll Lord Games, and I, you know, we did this interview on Monday, and we were talking about when you, Marin, met Mordenkainen in the Canadian airport.
Yes.
Elminster
and Mordenkainen travel to Canada from time to time because that's where Ed Greenwood is, and that's how Ed Greenwood writes about the Forgotten Realms, because he heard it firsthand from these two wizards who frequently visit him because their favorite drink in the world, in the worlds plural I guess, is Mountain Dew, so they go there to get extra.
Is Mountain Dew only available in Canada? No, on Earth. I see.
Same place, and, though. Conveniently enough.
And Mordenkainen got himself into a spot of bother here in Barovia, but Merin's other character, the Kalashtar Shivakri, helped probe his mind with Elminster's help and brought him back from that lost place. So they had this intense connection between the two of them. Then the offline party got the portal key that Mordenkainen needed to take a trip back to Canada, and they used the boarding gates and airports to hide their portal travel, so just not to freak out the locals. And Marin, as I texted her once, was in a Canadian airport, like in real life. So we just had this text back and forth where she saw Mordenkainen coming out of one of the boarding gates. Mordenkainen saw Marin, realized she was the player that controls Shivakri, freaked out and ran.
But how does Mordenkainen know that people that he might meet in the Forgotten Realms are being controlled by people in our realms?
He didn't, but he does now because he met because of that connection with Shivakri, and then he's meeting Marin. He now knows. So I think Ed Greenwood has some serious questions to answer that day. Oh, what have you done?
I'm just like bleeding out of my ears, eyes, and nose from just trying to like comprehend like the logistics of that.
Wackyverse.
Yay!
Wait, does that mean that our universe is now part of the Iwakiverse?
Why do you think there are Egyptian and Greek gods in Chisenta over on the Sea of Fallen Stars?
Just start foaming at the mouth.
It is a few short months until Spelljammer is released, and one of the places you can spelljam to is Earth. It exists in the Multiverse.
Which means that time moves much slower in the Iwakiverse than it does compared to our universe.
Yeah, but it's okay. Spelljammers just fly over there and do crop circles and then disappear again.
Right.
And get the locals to build funky pyramids.
Oh, I always thought it was aliens.
Yeah, ancient spelljammers.
Aliens.
It's a good impression. I like it.
I just don't have the hair for it.
I know. The stoned expression. Right. Okay. So, there we go. Everyone, chat. I hope you enjoyed that little bit of lore there that has happened. Now, Madame Aver looks up the hillside, and you do see Zuliker and the children and several other of the pack, that old fella. And I think Madame Ava like halloos that old guy. She's like, "Are you still alive?" He's like, "Ava, you old bat."
I can't tell if they're like friends, enemies, or lovers.
And Ava just turns around. She's like, "Over the ages, it's been a little of all of the above."
Hell yeah, brother.
You calling brother, you big furry oaf.
No, I was talking to the other guy. I give a quick dap up.
Just bumps himself.
Yeah. This guy can get it, man. This guy sucks.
Bjorn chest bumps him and just breaks his sternum.
Oh no! That's how I lost my brother. I don't know. That's not canon. Okay. Let's get out of here before they start Fighting?
Yeah, Baron Dragonborn. There was an ancient group of people in the area that's now Chisenta that had portals through to Earth, and they brought laborers and other people through from Egypt and ancient Greece to help.
Laborers.
Oh,
laborers.
Yeah, only laborers. Yeah, none of those fucking Taurus folk.
Yeah. They were all born in October. Actually,
and Taurus. I'm happy to say I had no idea which one is which month except my own.
I know mine and the one after, basically.
If you want that kind of stuff, come to Out of the Abyss, because two of our Out of the Abyss players are all into that. Sam and Buns into all that. Okay, now, as we were saying,
wait, there's a campaign happening.
Oh right, yeah.
Zulika says to you, We need to get these children off this mountain as quickly as possible. You lot, help them right some of the wrongs you have done. And she shouts at a group of the airwolves. And if you're willing, you will be airlifted to Argon Vostolt.
Hell yes.
Let's do it. I shift back into human, so I'm slightly lighter.
that helps. Your airwolf appreciates that much. And
I wonder if a werewolf has to follow the conservation of mass rule. Is it the same mass that just changes shape? Am I as heavy when I am a wolf as I am a man?
That's a good question. Thank you for the inspiration, Phantom.
Thank you.
Actually, I don't think they're languishing quite as much as it looks like they are. Sorry, I hadn't refreshed.
I don't have HP.
No, I mean, I think you might have had crystals already. That's what I'm saying. I can't remember. I'll check it out later, don't worry. I shall not let those dream pies go wasted, friends. Do not worry. Okay, so yes, with a whoosh, whoosh, whoosh of wings, the powerful airwolves, because they go into their hybrid form, because, you know, as Arakroka, they couldn't carry you. But they, you know, the winged hybrid werewolves do have the power to do that. And you...
I'm just muttering under my breath, fucking show-offs.
I think a bunch of the werewolves haul one of the cages out, and so all the kids like are in the cage, and they're just carrying the cage, as opposed, because there's not enough.
There's not enough
airwolves for every, you know, one for every person.
That's true.
You swoop down, buoying yourselves on the updrafts coming up the mountainside, and much faster than you took to get up here, you see the dark forests and the winding rivers, and far to the north, the huddled buildings of Valaki. And Lake Zarevich glistening, slate grey, in the against the northern mountains where Bjorn's home lies. But before...
Are we going to meet my parents in this arc? Whoa.
Before you get to the lake, you do see the river valley with the flooded, destroyed village of Berez. And atop the mountain, the hill overlooking that whole drowned valley, there is the dilapidated and yet still pretty majestic beacon of Argonvost, brightly shining, leading the way. As you come swooping through, you see the beacon of Argonvost just blasting up from the top of the mansion, guiding you home. And you go flying down towards that huge opening in the roof, and the airwolves spread out their wings at the last minute and break hard and swing up and set you relatively lightly down on the broken floorboards. And actually much cleaner now than it was when you first explored through there, Esmeralda, as the Arakokra have been busy. And you see Krig, Esmeralda, as he comes out. He's like, Esmeralda, I hope everything's okay.
Krig, it's good to see you.
I got a promotion.
Oh, congratulations! Sorry. What's your new position?
Work to do. Oh. I, Krig, Queen of Birds, Herald, do declare that Esmeralda and friends have arrived! The Queen will see you now! And he kind of gestures awkwardly towards the vast throne room where you'd met the revenants before. And you kind of look through, and the airwolves like shift back into just pure Arakokra form, and they all just go down on one knee in front of the Queen of Birds, and she kind of looks down at them, and there seems to be a certain seeking for forgiveness, and she decrees that, you know, this place does strange things to everyone. There has been all sorts of evil inclinations and bad thoughts going around the court and the Arakroka that have been swept through into Barovia with her, and she promises to judge them on their progress going forward from this day until they are returned to the elemental plane of air. Then shall they be judged and either forgiven or otherwise. And the airwolves, very thankfully, bid farewell and flap out through the roof again and head back towards the mountain. And then one of them remembers he's still got the key for the cage and comes back. And you let the kids out.
I'm just staying there, it's fine. You take care of them that way, they're all the same place.
Yeah. And you are back in Argon Vostot. What would you like to do?
Probably have a long rest.
One big bed.
Asara doesn't need hers at the moment.
No, she's fine. Put her on the shelf.
Oh god. Turn that thing away from us.
Aww.
I'm trying to think what it'd be. It's like Elf on the Shelf.
It's not her fault. He's the most creepy doll you've ever seen.
Elf on the Shelf. Drow like... on the...
Prow?
Prow? I don't know. Yeah, there's a ship. He's a ship.
Let's just say this entire time I've been holding Edgar. What's Mason's character's name again? Mm-hmm. It's Edgar, right?
Yep.
Yeah. I've just been like bringing Edgar along, who's like so shocked that he one-shotted a loop guru by accident that he passed out. And now we're like finally in a bed, I guess, for the first time in like 4 or 5 days. Like, mm-hmm. Holy shit. This is how people sleep? I just like... clump some shit together in the woods, man. This is pretty nice.
Well, you know that happens. I get confirmed.
I'm done for a long rest. Like, the kids are free. We have safety for once.
Mm-hmm. Relatively speaking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, relatively speaking. I guess we settle in for the night.
Bjorn, there's a... there's a whole menagerie of NPCs here.
Yes.
You meet...
actually?
Yes, we collected a lot of people.
There is a Modron here.
Hubert!
What?
Modron, the little robotic kind of things from the Plane of Law.
Oh, great.
It's like a little
he's very cute.
It's like a little metal box with spindly arms and legs, and it has a little short bow and a little sword. And it is continuously clanking around the exterior, patrolling.
Like, I'm trying to sleep, my little metal guy.
It's outside. It's
so brave.
So brave. That's cute.
Patrolling. Oh,
that's Mason's fault. Mason. Cool. No, it was Colby, wasn't it?
It was Colby's fault.
Yeah, it was Krieg's fault. Yep. Sorry. Yeah, yeah.
Who are these NPCs that we might bump into?
There's Hubert.
Hubert the Modron. Mm-hmm. There is... a saber-toothed tiger and a tiger.
Just a normal tiger and a saber-toothed tiger?
No, the saber-toothed tiger is awakened.
Oh, okay.
The tiger's regular.
Okay. So, like, do you, as an awakened saber-toothed tiger, just, like, have unawakened friends? Is that the other friends?
This is all rather new. I was turned by a druid and chased... an evil tiefling through a portal, and they didn't appear. But I did meet Ramses, so...
This is pretty cool.
He is much better spoken than Alfredo.
Okay.
What did I do wrong?
This is actually kind of fascinating, you know? All right. Four things, actually. Four things. I need four pieces of trivia from you. What is the best and worst thing about being awakened, and what do you miss and don't miss at all from being unawakened?
Wow.
Mm. Yeah, but Bay never thought about it.
I'm so glad Shabaki's not here to hear this. I awakened my pet snake.
The best thing is conversing with a myriad of individuals instead of eating them. The worst thing
is that
everybody wants to talk to you.
Ah, that's fair, yeah. You're kind of the hot girl at the party now, eh?
What do I miss? What do I miss? It's a little warm here. They came from Icewindale.
Right, yeah.
What don't I miss? Hairballs.
Oh, you stopped cleaning yourself the traditional cat way?
No, or... I can ask
hours every day.
I can ask people who would like to talk and have a conversation to brush me while doing it. That's great.
Oh, that's pretty neat. You know, I spend a little bit of my life just fully as a bear. I like didn't shift back for a long time, and I kind of forgot that I was also a man. And it was kind of chill, actually, not having like the social pressures of like, you know, human society and like, you know, things to do and places to be. And then like someone found me and was like, you're actually a shifter, you have to go, you know, ladies of the Danes. And I was like, oh, right, my whole fucking religion. I better get on that.
I have not looked into this religion thing much. Do you recommend it?
Yeah, like, have you heard of our Lord and Savior, the Lady of the Mountain Thane?
Lady and Savior?
Yeah. yeah, sure, Our Lady and Savior is the Lady of the Mountain Thane. I'm just, like, knocking on doors, handing out pamphlets. I've got, like, a nice, like, white button-down tee.
Hey, you're the one in shorts,
yeah. Full long sleeve. No. They have short sleeves, don't they? I'm, like, picturing, who is it? Jehovah's Witnesses?
Mormons.
Yeah, Mormons. They just go door-to-door with, like, their short white sleeve t-shirts. It's like, have you heard of the tower or some shit like that?
And, he's like, who are these ladies of the Fanes?
Obviously, Bjorn knows everything that they've learned.
Basically, what I said before, you know, the fey entities.
Yeah, exactly what I tell this man. This saber-toothed tiger.
And he's like, oh, like Ramses was telling me about in Valaki.
Yes, exactly that. Anyway, great conversation. Nice to meet you. I hope we can hang out and, like, I don't know, do animal shit. You know, if you ever want to, like, pretend you're not awakened for, like, a little while. Or, you know, we could be awakened and do taxes or whatever, you know.
Oh, didn't you hear? The evil Dark Lord is gone.
Oh, well, he's in, like, a puppet or something. Or, like, you know, like a creepy doll. But, yeah, he's no longer man in charge. Wait. Is that a secret?
Asara's doll gives you an accusing stare. Like, who are you calling creepy?
You know you're creepy. You absolutely know you're creepy. And that's not a shot against you. That's not your body. It is a creepy doll that you happen to be trapped in. No reason for you to take offense against the creepy doll you were put in. It's like if I tell a prisoner, man, this prison sucks, the prisoner usually agrees with me.
Recognize your inner beauty.
You are beautiful, no matter what creepy dolls say.
And Asara velvets off on a now oiled wheel.
Sure. Easy for you somewhere.
just riding a unicycle with a giant pin needle. Like, why is that doll so fucking creepy?
It's okay. They do not have the needle. It's okay.
Okay. Good.
Even though it's Asara, just don't trust it. Yeah. Okay. So.
You. NPCs.
You also meet up with what was the daughter? That you saved from thinking she was a cat.
Yes, long story.
No, I get it. I thought I was the bear once.
Stella,
thank you. Yes, Stella is also there. And A lot. There's a bunch more of my packs, like Edgar Bjorn.
It's Redwall, basically.
Yeah, bunch of raccoons everywhere.
But I'm used to that. I'm like, you know, like I used to like, you spend time with them. Pack village. But for the course, if you ask me.
Yeah. And yeah, you are treated to a nice hot meal and comfortable chairs and equally comfortable conversation, and you are all able to take the benefits of a long rest. I can't even plague you with nightmares in the Beacon of Argonvoss there.
Yay!
It's okay, Baron's got you for your nightmares there, Shiz.
I don't think I have sleep anyway, so...
Do you not need to sleep?
No, I finish rest in 4 hours. If I spend those hours in an active motionless state during which I retain consciousness. So I guess I just stare at the wall. I don't really know.
You're like Blair Witching this. You just wakes up and you just stood in the corner.
Yeah.
It's like, huh, did you...
Totally.
Are you cool? Did you get your rest and relaxation? Good morning, I guess.
4 a.m. Why are you awake? I'm done. How often do you, like, lapse?
It's like, imagine... Imagine you're at a sleepover and the person who only sleeps 4 hours a night wakes up early and then just goes into like your personal space and just waits for you to wake up. That's what you've done. Like, okay. Guess it's time to go save world or whatever.
How long were you there? It's like the full 4 hours.
Like, well, I slept for 4 hours and then you slept for four more. It's like, okay, cool.
Make sure you were safe.
Cool. I thought that was what creepy doll is for, but alright.
You're just like lying like perpendicular to him, like just like on your like good morning.
We're in like a triple bunk bed where it's like me at the top for some reason, Edgar in the middle and the creepy doll on the bottom.
No one is.
The creepy doll has an entire bed to itself. Actually, you know what, fair enough. I would give that bed to itself, yeah. If there's a king bed, like, it's in the middle of king bed.
No complaints.
Far away.
No complaints here, yeah.
Hilarious.
The day is yours, and the cloudy sky stretches across the vale. Light, but the sun never shines in Borovia.
Did we level up from killing that wolf, or... Do we ever level up in this game?
Level down.
I mean, level 10's already pretty high, I'm just wondering.
There, a little more to do with Asara before this particular quest is done.
Ooh.
I don't mind you leveling up, I get to throw powerful things at you.
Oh, great. No, keep them the same level, just make us beefier.
Oh, yes, Esmeralda needs more power. we had this conversation last night.
I've never actually leveled up with her, though. I got her at level 10, so...
True, true.
It's exciting.
Yeah. I don't know how you built your character, but it is finally so powerful. I just have, like, a normal paladin. I'm a normal vengeance paladin that happens to also werewolf. Happens to also werebear.
I was frustratedly shouting at her other character last night.
He was. My other character also is pretty good in combat.
Wait, do you play two characters in the verse? In the Iwaki verse?
Yeah.
What if they ever meet?
They haven't yet.
They haven't. Some campaigns have met other campaigns. Bjorn wants to level up, so Thamio's got some inspiration coming your way, my friend.
Ooh. Domo arigato.
Oh no, inspiration for Tia. That's not supposed to work, Thamio.
No, Thamio, no!
Oh, I see. You want harder fights, so I get the inspiration. Thank you,
I see. I rescind that Domo and that Arigato. Freaking Mazui, my dude.
Alright.
Motherfucking Hidoi.
I don't know how many draconic speakers there are in chat. We've had a couple of people come through in the past. Alright, so...
Just
wait, Tamio-san. don't inspiration, Johnny.
All right.
Koitsura buttabasu wa.
Sorry, excuse us, folks. We all speak.
Just
we all
alienating speak Draconic. Most of the most of the chat. Just learn Japanese, guys. It only takes 5 years.
I wonder if anyone's done a Warforged character called Mr. Roboto. Oh,
that's so good. Dibs on that. Dibs on that.
Where's Morris to do with the dolls? Do you mean Mason?
Okay, let's go free this cursed doll. Is that today's? I can hit you with an annyeonghaseyo and maybe a komsamnida, but that's it, man. Mm-hmm. My Hangul is non-existent.
Yeah. Apparently, very easy to learn, though. Designed to be that way, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is an alphabet. Mm-hmm. But I really struggle with the double consonants. All right. So, what is on today's roster? Doll or Mistwalking?
Edgar comes out with a clipboard and on his cap, Sporlax has got a little mini clipboard. Well, again, no arms or hands. it just like hovers next to him. So, yes. As you sit around that long table in that entranceway, which is just, this is a feature now, Esmeralda. In that main entranceway that had the statues of Argonvost in it. That's just, where you had that big meal when they had the parting of the ways before. That's when we had Vanta back for a brief while. Oh, piss off you. Have you got it? Or shall I?
Why don't you go for it? Mine's just a little...
No worries.
On the slower side.
Bye. Alright. Sorry about that, folks. Yeah, cheers, Baron. Okay. How do you feel is the best way to locate Asara's body?
I have locate object. So if I could... What's the range on that?
Isn't it like 1,000 feet or something?
1,000 feet. So it would have to be... I'd have to know roughly where she was. But if we knew roughly where she was...
If we could get within 1,000 feet of where she might be, yeah.
I do also have scrying.
Oh, yeah.
But I can only cast one of those either or in a day.
So either or?
I can't do both because they're attached to the Trokodex that
right.
I have.
Oh, yeah. And like at some point I want this reading that the lady was talking about. I want to be read or I want to read. I'm not sure how it works, but I'd love the written word. That they call me that Bjorn who loves to read. Yeah.
She's the best.
If we ever do a flashback scene, Bjorn, is that going to be baby Bjorn?
Only if I get a Batmobile.
A Batmobile?
Is that what they're called? Mobiles?
No.
I've literally been saying that word mobile the entire time.
You're right, mobile. You're right. She's referencing the vehicle in the Batman movies.
Yes. That's the joke I was making. Okay, anyway. My sun sign is Virgo, my moon sign is also Virgo, but my rising sign is Libra. As I bet you could guess.
You Libra, ship them off to Barovia. No, wait, just Santa.
What even is today? Jeez.
Oh, it's the 26th. For another 45 minutes.
It's funny, they all foolishly thought I was having a hard time with Cucumber on Saturday. I was like, nah, we're good. We're good. have you met some of my lot?
Your weekly players are trash. If you've ever been in ALT, you're probably trash. But like, the best kind of trash. You know, things that are someone else's treasure.
Yeah, watch that math around. You watch that math around these super senpai of yours.
Dice senpai.
Yeah.
That's true. Yeah. Okay. Probably scry because we don't know if we're within 1,000 feet of her right now.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I can do that. I just see if I have anything because it helps if I have I assume I don't have any of her body parts with me, but I
well,
do
you have her soul.
I might, yeah, well, that's actually a question. How does that work? If I scry on Asar, do I scry on her soul or do I scry on her body?
Can you read it for me?
Pardon me?
Could you read it for me?
Oh, yes. I can. It says, you can see and hear a particular creature you choose that is on the same plane of existence as you. Talking about the wisdom saving throw, just modified by how well you know the target, and the sort of physical connection you have to it. If it knows you're casting the spell, it can fail a save voluntarily if it wants to be observed. So, you can see and hear a particular creature that you choose. So I guess technically that would, I'd have to probably, I guess it'd be the soul, so I would try and scry the Carrionet in that case, but I wouldn't know what it looks like.
Oh, so technically you have the Carrionet's body, and you're trying to track its soul, or you have the soul of the body you're trying to track.
That's true, the Carrionet counts as a body part.
It's not a part, it's a whole body.
Yeah, I mean, it's a safe modifier of negative 10 if I have the body. So I guess, would that be how it works?
Yeah, Jack, please let us do this. Is that how it works? See, that's how it works.
It's fascinating.
It's kind of a question. You see the entire body, the thing you're trying to observe. And you see the rest of it.
So what does it say about the minus 10? If you have the body?
No. The roof is modified. First, by how well I know the target. Mm-hmm. Like, if I know really well, then they have a negative modifier. And also by the connection I have to it sort of physically. So if I have a likeness of a picture, it's a little bit of a modifier. If I actually have possession or a garment that belongs to them, even more. And if I have a body part, like hair or nail or whatever, then there's an additional modifier to make it harder to pass the save, basically.
What's your save DC on that? So you have the whole body, so it's minus 10 to their roll. So they could roll an 18, but it would only amount to an 8. Hell, they could roll like a 19.
I think that's how Don rules it. And I also...
That 20 is the only thing they would have to roll to escape that. Yeah,
would I have technically met the target? I don't know. Well, but have I met it? I guess I've met it.
You met the body it's in.
But have I met it? I mean, I guess I've seen... the doll. I haven't, been engaged in discourse with it, but...
Yeah, how many bodies does a soul count for? I know this isn't my fourth year philosophy class, but can we get into the metaphysics of a soul and a body for a second?
I think that was the Descent into Avernus campaign. It's like, what's the mileage on a soul?
Yeah. Is it just the one life or is it every life it's ever lived?
we did a cool homebrew mechanic where they could just drain a soul coin to heal, like a healing potion.
Oh, that's so cool.
But then they got the flashbacks from the soul that was in it. So I was like rolling random NPCs and one of them was like a gnome. It was like a gnome hunter like running through the forest with his like otter companion or something.
Aww, that's quite nice.
Yeah, as they consumed his soul to make themselves better. Okay, wow, this is a very interesting one, and probably not something they considered when creating the Carrionet.
Probably not.
I mean, think you should just let us do it, man.
The other thing here is the focus that's worth at least 1,000 gold pieces.
But if it's connected to the Taroka, or do I not have one of those things that I bought with the money that I had? Forget.
Can we ask our lich friend for...
Wait a second, what is the Booster for Souls?
For a diamond, I guess?
No, I think it's... you can use an action to cast one of the following spells from it. So I'm casting it from the deck, I guess.
Okay.
It doesn't specify either way, but it says I can cast those spells.
Okay. So...
does that mess up your plans? Sorry.
Ok. Okay, so the target makes a wisdom saving throw modified by how well you know the target and that physical connection that you have.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I'm going to say
medit, I guess.
The scrying spell focuses in on the physical location of a person, therefore their physical form. So you will be able to scry on Azara's body.
Okay.
Now, you don't have part of the body. You have the soul. So I'm going to say it's not going to give you the minus 10. But
I mean, God doesn't want your body; he wants your soul. I think the soul is more valuable than 10.
But it distinctly says a physical part of them.
I'd probably be able to hunt down one of her possessions or garments from the rooms she's in at Arkenvostwald, though.
Possession, yes. And also you have
like her knives.
Your familiar knowledge, so it's minus 5 there. And then so it'd be minus 9.
Okay.
It's still pretty great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So yeah, I will try and scry in that case, and it'll be a wisdom save of 18 with a minus 9 modifier.
Can they?
They would have to hit a nat 20.
I mean, depending on the wisdom.
Well, no, because it's not. Remember, nat 20 is only an automatic success in a fight. Yeah, it's only when you're rolling to attack this automatic hit. So, yeah, if your modifier is not enough, then even a nat 20 is not going to be enough. You're not skilled enough.
Yeah, if they rolled a 20, they would get a 12.
11.
And your thing is 18, so it doesn't matter.
Well, it depends what their modifier is. Let's see what their modifier is.
Oh, what their modifier is. Because
they have a plus, yeah. So I'm just pulling up the Carrionette stat block. Because it's the wisdom of the Carrionette.
Hopefully it's not very wise.
We shall see. Thanks, sir.
I mean, it would need a... Plus
thanks for helping us, being with us to puzzle this one out, folks. What do you think? what do you think in chat, folks? What would you say?
Funny one.
Do you agree that the soul is more valuable than the body?
Okay. So. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, we're not gonna roll because they're only a plus 2. It's only a plus 2 at minus 9, Baron, so the best they could ever roll is 22, which would make it down to 13. Hey, Charlie, how you doing, mate? So, they can't.
Yeah, fair.
With that familiarity, because it's Azara, right? They can't they can't defend against it.
Yay!
We got her.
I thought I'm doing this by doing something.
Mission accomplished, folks. We got it.
I assume. The pulling up the cards and trying to sort of triangulate that way.
Well, let me just do this.
Okay.
You have the Mapak and various folks clear away the breakfast things, leaving you here with the dull lights of the Barovian morning coming through the windows into the hall of Arkenvostwald, as you methodically lay out the cards one by one in the arrangement that will allow you to cast the spell and use the divination powers of a Taroka deck to look into the future, as this is what they're designed for. But the way the scrying spell works is it continuously looks just very, very briefly into the future, so it knows where they're about to be in like a second. So you're basically seeing now as you're just, your vision is skipping. And as you lay the cards on the table, how does it activate? You lay them in a ring and it creates a scrying pool in the middle of the cards. So what does that look like?
I think it's probably the cards, the numbers and like the lines in the middle just probably light up and sort of are really sort of highlighted in the middle. Comes this sort of shimmering, kind of misty mirror type thing where you can sort of look in and see these forms, kind of, or I guess the one form, in a kind of like not particularly like clear, but you know, a sort of softly muted. You can see what's going on basically. instead of curling of bits of mist coming off the edges.
Yep.
You focus on the pool, and you feel your vision being drawn into it. Bjorn, you see Esmeralda just clutching onto the back of one of the high-backed chairs here, staring intensely at just cards laid on the table. You don't see anything in the middle of the cards, and this is only visible to her. And Esmeralda, as your view is pulled down through into the scrying pool, your vision starts to focus again, as if you're passing through those mists, and you uncomfortably be reminded of when you were reborn by the dark powers, and you see a corridor.
Oh, not a forest, okay.
No, not a forest. You see a corridor, dusty, worn carpets, old, faded, trappings on the wall, and you see a female figure. Shorter than Asara is, with kind of hair, long hair hanging down. Your view is from behind, and can you hear as well?
The way I've seen the scry spell be used before,
you can
like,
see and like, hear. Hmm. Yep, I can see and hear both.
Okay.
You're just haunting them temporarily.
Yeah, basically.
Yep.
You hear the footfalls of this person moving down this hallway, and you hear a voice from behind, from out of view, behind where your scrying point is hanging. And as you hear the voice, you think, confused, thoughts to yourself, it's like, this can't be true, this can't be right. As from behind, you hear Krieg's voice.
What?
Krieg, who is here at the castle, announcing us?
Stella, have you had breakfast yet? And the figure in front of you, walking down the hall, turns, and it is
shit.
Stella.
It's here?
Wachter from Valaki, and you look over, and because you used to have eyes on the rest of the do you have awareness of the room where you are? Oh no, it doesn't matter. Before you
I'm in that room,
but you can't see what she's seeing.
Oh right.
So Esmeralda, you see Stella Wachter, the girl that you rescued from Valaki, turn and smile, presumably at Krieg, who's behind your point of view. And you know, as you cast this spell, Stella Wachter was finishing breakfast across the table from you.
Yeah.
Remember, Asara had the hat pin of disguise.
She's here. Downstairs, then.
It looks like a corridor in Argenvostholt, and
oh boy,
Krieg is there.
Krieg is there.
All right. Well, we are gonna wrench ourselves out of that scry thing.
So what did you see? Was it Jill?
She's here. We need to get upstairs. Oh, hello, people.
Okay, as you come out of the scrying circle, various spirits of Barovians, past and present, are drawn through with you and raid in. Hello, Josh. Hello, everyone from Corsair's Cove. Welcome in, raiders. Hope you had a fantastic session. I know part of it was fantastic because I watched it. Thank you for raiding in, my friends. How's everyone doing? Everyone do check out Corsair's Cove right there in chat. Give them a follow. Fantastic Humblewood content. We have a Mapak here, but they are not here right now, I'm afraid. But everyone, just do jump in there. Corsair's Cove knows what's up. Exclamation mark, enter to get into our giveaway from the fabulous Troll Lord Games. Your choice of a single product from their digital catalogue, and you can take your pick from the catalogue over there. Wonderful, wonderful support from Troll Lord Games this week, because in a matter of hours, I think it's about 32 hours, 31 hours left, the Kickstarter that they are running at the moment is going to wrap up. So if you are not already, head on over to their Kickstarter. Here's the link in chat for you guys. I've been given some sneak peeks, and it is awesomely written. A really nice adventure, very, very flavorful setting. This Kickstarter is called The Undying War. It's a level 1 through 13 adventure. Really, really fantastic stuff. And if you would like to get in there and get it cheaper than it will be when it's available later on, Kickstarter is always a bit of a better deal. There's also lots of stretch goals that have been opened up, and all sorts of amazing things. There's a really good explanation and introduction to the adventure path on the Kickstarter, so please follow that link over there. Jump it on, open in another tab, and have a look at that. As we continue to our rather dramatic reveal here, they are looking for their drow friend's body that has been stolen away by an evil toy. And as they were looking for where this evil toy is puppeteering their friend's body around Barovia, they have discovered it is here. In the building they are in. That's within the walls!
The ball came from inside the castle!
Oh, God, no. Yeah, that was a better one. That went aliens.
I mean, they're both pretty bad. Let's not pretend like either of them are good.
Thanks, Esmeralda. Yeah, the scry was from within the wall. I'm right here. they've discovered that Stella Wachta, the girl that they rescued... Mimslot, thank you for the follow. As they rescued Stella Wachta from Valaki,
the haunted meat mech of Stella Valacta.
She is across the table finishing breakfast, but when Esmeralda scryed on their friend, she was also in a corridor upstairs in the mansion here with their Arakokra friend, Krik. So, as we return to that revelation, good luck to everyone. Welcome in, everybody. Hope you're doing really, really well. What do you do?
Well, I'm probably frantically drawing my cards together. Like, she's here, we have to go now. And again, I can probably try and drag Bjorn, but he's giant and I'm not.
No, I'm coming with you. I'm not,
great. Well,
I'm not resisting.
I'm just like going into full run. And as I'm running,
let's
I'm reading a number about how to fix this doll problem. Do I have to poke it with the pin? What do I have to do? I don't remember.
We put the pin in the creepy doll's hand, we throw a creepy doll up. Pin goes in bodies, does switcheroo.
I'm also bringing Asara the doll with me, to be clear. I'm not going to leave her on the shelf while this happens. That'd be unfortunate.
Don't forget your drow on the prow.
yeah, so I am booking it towards whoever I think Krieg is going to be.
More raiders!
Who's that?
More raiders!
Hey, Sanjididi, how are you doing?
Welcome, everybody.
Welcome in, everybody.
Yay.
Welcome, welcome. We have a massive Trollog Games giveaway going on at the moment. Jump in there, exclamation mark, enter. It's all in honor of their fantastic Kickstarter, which only has a number of hours left. Head on over there. I won't do the full spiel again because we're trying to adventure here. But we are very, very happy to be sponsored by our wonderful friends at Trollog Games. Wonderful folks over there with some very creative stuff going on in their Kickstarter. Check it out. It's fantastic. Okay.
Books sent to you if you win. Real books for your shelves.
Yes, indeed. Well, real books are giving it in the one shot tomorrow, so don't miss that.
Oh, okay, sweet.
Good to see you, my friend. Good to see you. Thanks for coming by. Okay, so the carrier net has control.
We need to put the pin in the doll's hand, and the doll holding the pin used to poke the carrier net.
Yeah.
Or the body.
Yeah.
Lovely. So I think I'm not going to bolt headlong. Actually, I might be trying to sneak. I have a plan. I have invisibility, which I never use.
Yes, the swap is undone if the controlled body takes damage from the silver pin.
Can you cast invisibility on both of us?
Just on me, unfortunately.
All right.
But it lasts for a full minute. Anything I'm wearing or carrying is invisible as long as it's on my person. So
okay,
if
so
I were to carry the
so
pin...
So I'll just jump on your back and you'll carry me and then we'll...
This is true.
Absolutely.
I can try and carry you.
full wear
bare
mode.
Fine anyway, it's fine.
She's wearing me, John. I don't know what the issue is. You've never worn a bear belt before? Not while the bear was still in it?
No, I have not.
So enough. I probably would be trying to hurry sneakily towards whichever quarter that would be. Under convenience to roll a stealth check, or
See the problem. I mean, you haven't I mean, since you took Argovostok, you haven't actually spent that much time here. You've been out and about a lot, so you're not quite sure where they are. But
that's fine.
You know it was up above because Krieg has been up there the whole time.
I'll go up there and I guess try and make as little noise as possible. And once I get a sense of if I hear voices or anything, I'm instantly going to go invisibility and scoot in that direction.
Okay. So yeah, you go tearing through up this sweeping staircase that curls up from this new dining room of everyone's and up to the upper levels. Give me a perception check.
Okay, that is not amazing. Oh, what is today? It's nat 20.
Nice.
I see everything.
If you got a close, let those phoenixes fly.
Yay!
Nice. Okay, so yeah, you, with your keen hearing, augmented by your recent proximity through the scrying spell, hear Krieg's grating, annoying voice.
Krieg, don't listen to him.
It's very unfair.
His job is speaking loudly, so I think he should be edified.
It's like, I now herald that I am walking down this corridor.
Look at me, here I go.
You do hear right foot. You hear Krieg's voice from another floor up towards where the Queen of Birds and everyone is, in conversation.
Okay, I'm not necessarily as talented a velveteur as Asara, but I will try to velvet as well as possible up the stairs. And yeah, just before I think they will see me, I'm gonna just whoop. I'm very excited. I've never done this before.
Okay. So, give me a stealth check with advantage.
Ooh! Like the sound of that.
Now, everyone, if you would... Oh, awesome. Everyone, would, please imagine this music with Bjorn just like it's like a camera like attached to Bjorn's forehead. It's like running down the corridors. He turns to the left. There's like two twin girls stood there. It's like, come and play, Bjorn. Come and join us forever and ever. And you're like, no, I'm too busy. suddenly Bjorn's on a big wheel.
There's like an elevator that opens and like blood comes out. Well, the blood, because I'm
God damn it. Did you guys not clean up? You're just tearing through the building after Esmeralda, who annoyingly just vanishes at one point.
I'm like, I guess just following her scent. Do I have that ability?
Well, yeah, absolutely.
What are you implying?
Well, you smell like a reborn corpse, so.
Rude.
I would take offense to that, but I really can't.
To the facts that I've just said, you'll take offense to facts?
I freshly showered reborn corpse, thank you very much.
Okay, Asara's passive perception is only 16, so as Mimsla, right? Aren't they beautiful? Fantastic art. Recently we have made Emma City art. Actually, I didn't shout out the artist. Thank you, Mimsla. That's a good reminder. Babart, indeed.
Gibbyar?
Jack Cassidy, thank you for that follow. Good name.
Oh,
okay.
That's a good name.
Yeah, it came out of our Deadlands campaign the other week. that is the wonderful Emma City Art, who we have made our official artist for Phoenix Uwaki for the ongoing future. They're fab. There will be some new art on the way because we have our summer campaign kicking off next month. So do make sure you stick around and see the awesome designs that are coming up. Homebrew Coffee Co., hello!
Yay!
Oh, and thank you for that joining the Discord. Welcome in. Alright, so... Oh, I could go a nice like cafetiere coffee right now. That'd be cool. Okay, that's probably not a good idea, this close to midnight. Bye. yes, you are charging towards the voices of Esmeralda and you hear them round the next corner. What do you do?
I will cast Great Invisibility for the first time ever. Yay, I'm very excited. So I'm invisible until this ends, and anything I'm wearing and carrying invisible.
Is this the one that doesn't break if you attack?
Yes.
God.
I have that one too! I've waited to use it, but it didn't seem quite the right time. I didn't need to.
I've got my inspiration crystal, I might need it. Okay, as you, and then you're just gonna walk around the corner, or what do you do?
I mean, I've got myself a 27 working for me, so I'm gonna scoot her in the corner, and as soon as I get close to her, I can just like jab her with the pin and try and cause damage.
Hey, Dan.
Okay, you look Yeah, you.
Wait, so you're holding the doll. The doll's holding the pin. You're jabbing the doll and the pin into this person.
No, she can just use the pin. It's okay. The doll doesn't have to hold the pin.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I thought it was doing a switcheroo again.
So, you come around the corner and you see, as you're breathing a little heavily, but you manage to control it and keep a lid on your out of breath state here. And your monster hunter instincts kick in as you stealth down the shabby hallway towards, for all appearances, Stella and Krig in a conversation.
What are they talking about?
Just talking about, Stella's asking Krig what it's like to fly and seems very curious about that. So you think maybe the Carrionettes might want an Aarakocra body.
Okay, that's fine. I feel reassured by this.
But you're lucky because you've got the pin. Usually the Carrionette, the control body takes the pin. And so they just keep shifting through people like across.
Oh, that's so cool. I love that. It's so creepy. I'm glad it's not happening.
Next time.
That's not what I was implying.
So
you can make me romance as many dinosaurs as you want, but just take me out of this creepy doll factory.
You do creep on up there, and yes, you may give me an attack with advantage. Thank you, Homebrew Coffee. Those are inspiration and disadvantage crystals, where people pay for them with the Dream Pie channel points to give boons to our players, or like otherwise.
Bonus for attacking with a pin? Would it be like an unarmed strike, or would it be like a tiny rapier?
I'll say unarmed.
Okay.
Basically.
Ooh, one is a nat 1 and one's a 12.
Okay.
Wait, do you have an inspiration crystal?
Yes.
Can I use it? I already have advantage, though.
You can reroll one dice.
I will reroll. In that case, it's my inspiration crystal. I don't use them very often, so...
Reroll that 7.
See how this does. 18!
18!
Better.
18!
Okay.
18.
So, as you creep up... I was going to do this whole cool, like, Krig hostage situation thing, but never mind.
I'm sorry. I keep ruining your plans without meaning to.
Fucking invisibility.
You can still...
you pad on down the hall there. They do not hear you coming, engrossed in conversation, fascinated by the wings. You can see Stella kind of, like, looking at Krig's plumage. And...
Who dares?
Now, sorry, the invisibility, does it break when you attack?
I don't think so.
No, that's greater invisibility.
It's greater invisibility.
It does not break.
Okay.
You're welcome, Matt. You know I have that.
So... okay. DM.
It's a spider,
DM
right?
Researches all monsters with true sight. Lee, don't encourage them.
No, keep it. We're very incorrigible,
Lee,
actually.
Lee, you misspelled DM. Okay.
No, he got the M and the D in there. He just added a bunch of other shit around it.
Thank you, Lee. I jest.
You have hopefully just returned.
Hey, everyone, there's the Kickstarter link there. Do check it out. It's awesome. Okay. So, Esmeralda, you stalk forward, and as the Carrionette inside Asara's body, pretending to be Stella Wachter, reaches up towards... It's okay. Reaches up towards Krig's plumage. Where do you attack?
If there's anything... I mean, I probably know Asara's usual garb. So presumably if she has her like arms bared, or if she's like shoulders bared, or if like her neck's exposed or whatever.
She's in your fucking face.
I feel like she'd be angry if there's like a zip that came out of that though.
You'd be angry you returned her to her body? Wow.
I probably would, like, you know, if I think, you know, if, like, her neck is supposed to probably, like, jab into her neck.
It's like you hit an artery. It's like you're back in your body. I'm dying.
It's a very small pin. I mean, it's like a large chunky pin. I'm not coming back. It's more like wherever bees are reasonable, and I don't have to reach very far to get. But she's like just standing in the hallway. I'm like, yeah. Think.
Okay. Yeah, just the invisibility just completely, you know, makes her completely unaware and undefending here. And yeah, you prick the skin on the back of the neck, causing a single point of piercing damage. I think it does back, have.
So in case I slap like a bug, then one... I will not be there.
Oh no, could you also roll me a d6, please?
I can roll you a d6. Wow. A d6, that's a powerful pin. That's gonna be 4.
Okay. So, you kill cause her. 1 piercing damage and 4 necrotic damage.
I'm worth taking it. This. Just give me later.
I'm taking this off of Sarah's. No, she would have had a long rest by now.
Is this an actual player or is it just like an NPC?
Nope, this is a player. This is Stephanie's character.
Oh.
Yeah.
So is Stephanie going to join Barovia campaign?
During the summer break, yep.
Hell yeah!
Everyone, Stephanie is back. Asara, okay. Asara Bell returns.
Yay!
We ruined the surprise.
I think the people that knew had guessed, I assume.
Yeah.
Where is
she? I thought I knew, but now I know.
Myself's done, kind of hanging there. With
Asara, get out here! There she is.
Chekhov's creepy old doll.
Okay, there's the art there, Bjorn. It's fab. If you've seen it before.
She's I love her art. So pretty.
Where?
Oh, it's on stream now.
Oh, let me put up
stream. Nope. Thamiel, you are directly responsible for stealing Xenicus away forever, so.
Damn. That's good art. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, we would hire that.
We should, shouldn't we? Esmeralda, as in Marin, did you see the art that Thamiel commissioned of that NPC that took Xenicus away in the Discord?
I think I saw it, yeah.
So good. Yeah. So good.
Yeah.
Just like the lining on the jacket and the
so book, talented.
The book
rude.
The book holsters.
You should make them like the main artist or something. Oh my god, you guys. Is that wild?
I might just do that. It wasn't I know it wasn't forever. Like art? I know it wasn't forever. okay. So you you do this damage and you do see this black veins of necrotic energy like coming off the pin. You're like, oh, am I the bad guy?
I'm good.
And Bjorn, the Carrionette's toy. I mean, everyone back home needs to share in this, right?
You all need to share our pain. The more people see it, the more the suffering is diffused across, you know, multiple people, and it's all lessened.
Right. I pulled up stream.
That's how it works.
I can see the bats flying around. I see our many, many diamonds. I love them.
Where are you?
Wait, Phoenix the Diamond. How fucking dare you?
That was Thamiel before. Remember, he's trying to challenge you so you can level up.
Yeah,
of course.
Yeah.
You caused it, as I recall.
Where? Oh, God.
Am I the problem?
Where did we put that picture? Damn it, I can't remember where we put it.
I mean, it can stay lost forever. I really don't mind. I just actually have to bring
it
here. Cool. Be safe.
We got that mysterious Velaki figure.
Monster I don't know if we're trying to have a full philosophical discussion here, LHawk99. Is that Lee?
Lee, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know if we're trying to have a full philosophical discussion here, but wouldn't that just be twice as much burden in the world? If I am suffering and my friend begins to suffer with me, now we are both suffering. We have individually experienced equal amount of suffering, thus there is now twice of it.
But isn't the problem shared a problem heart?
I mean, you're carrying one load, yes, but this is now a curse you're inflicting on all of us.
I got that, sorry.
We are not carrying
you
a load.
You have escaped today, friends.
Imagine just
do not have to see the creepy doll.
Just a creepy doll. Just imagine, like, you know, close your eyes, picture like a creepy doll. It's singing Ring Around the Rosie. It's got like that like Victorian doll hair that's actually like gold, like straw or whatever. And it's like probably like, you know, purple or gray. And it's like on a unicycle.
Literally the worst the worst doll. Oh, it's in the Roll 20.
It's the platonic ideal of creepy doll.
Hmm? I'm just gonna drop it right on the overlay. Here you go, folks. Enjoy. So there we are.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, there she is.
The delay. Oh no!
I am very unhappy.
Asara's two forms, final form, and the drow. Okay, so yes, the Carionet doll, which is in your arms, Bjorn, as you come chasing after Esmeralda.
I'm holding it.
starts to shake violently, as if there's like a very, very localized earthquake going on. It's just like rattling, all of its parts rattling, and its little teeth like chittering and chattering away. And you see Esmeralda. You see Stella Wachter's body just go and like stiffen. And Krieg, still not able to see you, he's like, Stella? Yeah. Stella, are you okay? Somebody help!
He's like, I'll catch her, I guess.
And so she's just like hanging, like, diagonally.
Yeah. I scream to you, Krieg. I say, get away from her, Krieg! That's not who you think it is! Get away, Krieg! Fly away!
And Krieg's like, oh, not again! And so he's running off down the corridor.
Krieg gets it.
he's not his first rodeo. Action. and goes charging off down the corridor in the opposite direction.
It's not his first Hinamatsuri.
Yes. I must protect the queen! And he goes just running off in the other direction. And
required no convincing. He just believed.
Oh, yeah.
He has no reason to doubt me.
Yeah. Bjorn, my friend, could you please make me an athletics check?
But I only have a +8 to that, my guy. Is 21 okay?
Okay, 21 against the +2 acrobatics check. The carrionette was trying to wriggle free and escape. I rolled a natural 1.
Oh, thank God.
A total of 3.
Nice.
If you rolled a nat 20, like, you would have tied me.
Means it would have beat it, yeah. It would have been.
Yeah.
That was the only option. So, yes, the toy struggles and writhes and moves violently in your arms, Bjorn. But you are too strong, and it's not able to escape. You are grappled.
I like place it against the ground with my arms, with my hands still holding it. I put my feet on it, so now I've drawn and quartered this doll with my foot, and like my shadow's like helping me. It's got like, it's like, you know, creepy shadow hands just also pulling at the doll, and I'm just like, can I kill the doll? I'm just holding my like. My longsword above it. Like, can I kill this doll? Invisible Esmeralda, can I kill the doll?
I'd probably be waiting for any kind of sign from Asara that she's back in her body before I give the go ahead. We don't take any risks.
She is.
Is she reacting at all?
She's limp and unconscious.
Okay.
But
maybe we should wait until we actually hear from her, until we're absolutely certain.
Okay. I sheath my sword while still stepping on this doll and get up my 50 feet of rope that every adventurer needs for some reason. I just tie up the doll.
In 50 feet of rope, just this giant rope ball with the doll in the middle.
I swear there's a doll here.
Just roll it down the hall.
Esmeralda, do you do anything to Asara?
That's healing word or something. Wait, I can heal her, actually.
I'm not a healer.
Come on, paladin.
Yeah.
My one failing.
Okay,
I'm not
I go
healer.
Over and I don't know, I use 1 point of HP to bring her back from unconsciousness.
For a little bit.
I just do like 1 point of lay on hands. It's like, you're alive.
Yeah, and she, the eyes flutter, and she's like, oh. That doll was very cramped. And just like stretches back into her natural body.
Now I kill the doll.
Okay, roll me with advantage, because it's prone.
Do it.
Oh. Mm.
Do it. Come on.
Do I want to?
Please.
Do I want to, like, nat 20 on this doll?
Please.
Right. Can I, are we in initiative?
No.
Can I cast haste on myself and then still do an attack roll?
Of course, yeah.
Okay, I use my third level spell slot.
Yes, do it.
Cast haste.
So Esmeralda, you see Bjorn go into a blur of furry emotion.
So I get two attacks. Haste gives me two attack turns, so I get four attacks in total this round.
Mm-hmm.
So first one's a 27.
8d20. Just do it in roll 20. Just roll 20.
Oh, okay. What's the number for
/R?
Yep.
Space 8d20.
8d20.
All one word.
Are you kidding? Oh, what's in that one?
There is. Okay. So yeah. Esmeralda. Well, actually, just before we do this, roll me.
Wait, I have an advantage on them. So
roll me a d20.
Do the lower ones count?
Have you advantage, you have to roll 16 of them.
Just a moment.
So I have four attacks. So I should have rolled 8d20. Is it like the highest eight or the ones that hit?
It'd be the highest four.
Sorry, the highest four.
It'd be the highest four that hit, I guess.
The highest four hit, but what we're referring to, what we are dancing around to surprise Esmeralda, is whenever you attack a creature with this weapon and roll a one on the attack roll. So you rolled a one on the attack roll.
I did.
It doesn't matter if it's the one that hits or not. So I need you to roll one more d20, please.
Me?
Ooh.
Yes.
Also in the chat? Or also in roll 20?
No, that's fine.
Okay, cool. Just roll any old d20. Roll it. D&D Beyond. I got a hot 14.
14. Okay. So, Esmeralda, you see... you see Bjorn...
First my attacks hit. First all my attacks hit.
...start blurring and just going into this... Just a strange, like, accelerated movement. This new sword that he took from the Amber Temple flashes out down towards the prone and bound form of the Carrionette, and with one strike, bang, 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 just chops it up into so many parts that even Blinsky could not recycle them and use them in other toys. Just absolutely smashing. And as he slops the weapon plunged into the doll, one last time, and Asara's like, thank you very much. You see him just leaning heavily on the blade. He's breathing heavily. And then you
that's
see...
27 points of damage, by the way.
Yeah, it's completely obliterated.
Okay, yeah.
You see, it doesn't even have any attacks. It's this tiny little thing. The only thing it can do is the pinprick to try and curse somebody. You see these dark tendrils of energy starts to come off the hilt of the sword, and they start to wrap around his arms. And Bjorn, you like, Chess knows, but Bjorn, yeah, he's like, Shadow, what are you doing? And the Shadow's like, no, it's not me.
say that every freaking time.
These dark tendrils of energy start to wrap around your arms, Bjorn, like coming up and completely encasing him, Esmeralda. Bjorn disappears from view as he is completely entombed within this like cocoon of this dark shadow.
Have you ever seen Fullmetal Alchemist? And there's all those like very tiny black hands attached to very, very long like noodle arms.
Vaguely,
I imagine it's those things coming out of my sword and then making like a cocoon around me. Because those are creepy as hell, and I love those.
That sounds creepy. Good. I love it.
Like that. Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay. So that happens.
That's fine.
And then the cocoon type shape starts to shift and move, and it goes shorter and out to the sides, wider.
A medium-sized beast.
And it starts to undulate and move, and as the shadowy covering starts to recede and fall off, Bjorn.
Can I before the dust settles, you hear like echoing through these halls a very deep, a very like croaky.
What?
The shadows recede, and before you, in the halls of Argon Vostholtz, no longer stands Bjorn, the paladin of the Ladies of the Thanes. There is. And we leave you with this today, folks. a giant frog.
What?
So.
Now can giant frog talk?
Off, right?
Do giant frog have lines?
You have the it's clickable there in your magical item. If you click on the name of the magical item, it comes up.
Yeah, but like,
are you completely like
it just says giant frog?
Or are you like?
It's clickable. You get the stat block.
Okay.
Languages, nothing.
Nope. Okay.
So it's like, is the polymorph more than a wild shape? I guess.
Rip it.
All right. This is fine.
Bjorn, you're polymorphed. I think that means you take on the mental characteristics as well.
Yeah, I
have no idea.
Personality, but you lose your intelligence and things. Yeah, it goes to the frog stats.
Yeah, your intelligence is now 2, so you have a -4.
You still remember your friends.
cool. Now I'm frog. is what I think in my own head. In my own head.
This is new.
This is a new development.
And
plus 3 to stealth, though. That's new for me.
There you go, folks. Asara's soul is returned to Asara's body. The carrionette is destroyed. And we have a new giant frog companion. So, a massive... massive thank you to everyone that's joined us already.
I do a slimy thumbs up.
It's got a big old smile on its face.
I do a shrug like, it's a living. I'm a Flintstones character.
Hang on, we brought up the doll. We should bring up the frog too.
Yes, I would like to see this frog, please.
Okay,
do frog wield sword? In mouth or in paw? Paw? What do frogs have?
Paw? Feet?
Arms?
I would say feet, I think.
Can frogs handle tools?
Well, you're very cute.
Am I like a Wind in the Willows frog, or am I like a anatomical frog?
As you go off in your little convertible sports car.
Pretty anatomical,
looks like. So, everyone, as we leave the halls of Argon
Am I one of those racist frogs that all the memers are using?
No, you're good.
Am I Pepe?
No, you're good. As we leave Barovia for one more time there. Last chance, everyone. If you want the chance to win the fantastic Troll Lord Games giveaway, a free copy of any single product from their catalogue, any singular project. None of the bundles and things, of course. But, hey, thanks for that follow, Anthanum. If you've given us a follow today, thank you to everyone who has. We are barreling towards 1,400 followers. It's fantastic. If you've given us a follower today, please, if you give us a follower, please accept this person. If you have given us a follow, please keep an eye on your Twitch whispers, as we shall be sending you our followers' Discord invites. I saw a couple of people jump in there. Homebrew Coffee jumped in there, I think. Coffee Co. Mm-hmm. Whilst we were online, thank you so much for that. And you can come over there, hang out, share your projects in the self-promotion channel. Look for players, look to be a player, just share news, enjoy what's going on in the Wackyverse, D&D in general, and just hang out. Share some cool food pics, whatever you've got going on. There's lots of different channels in there. I hope you're able to join us. It's a nice place to be. Now, if you are able to get some of this fantastic Troll Lord Games, what will you do with it? ! In the chat for your chance to win, everyone. I'm going to close up the giveaway before, just as we finish up here. But before we do that, let us do a quick roundup of what is happening here until we're in Barovia next time. Tomorrow, or tonight, if you're in that part of the world, we will be returning to Prismere, back to our Wild Beyond the Witchlight campaign. The loose ends have been tied up. There is naught else to do but confront the hag above Lorna and escape in a swamp gas balloon as they fly across and out beyond the boundaries of... Hang on. I wonder... Sorry, folks, let me just double check that's working properly. It's not coming up. No, that worked for that one there. Everyone, please... let me do a quick refresh on this as well. If that didn't work for you, please give it another go. Because that should be, and it's not followers only or anything, so it should be open for everybody. Oh, and thanks for sticking around. Did you come with Corsair's Cove? Okay, so as we are wrapping up here, yes, we will be well beyond the witchlighting tomorrow. But then, later on Friday, wherever you are in the world, we have a very special one-shot as we delve into the Barren Forest, which is a... hang on, I got that name right. The Barren Wood, sorry, I was close. And we delve into the Barren Wood as our adventurers do take a glimpse, a sneak peek, if you will, into the world of that Trolllord Games Kickstarter. Please do jump on over. Let's make sure everyone is in there. Yeah, Anthem, I see you there now. That's probably showing up properly now. And you can get your chance to see what all of the fuss is about with this amazing Kickstarter. All the stretch goals reached already, they have funded already, so you will be definitely getting what you pay for. Please do take your chance and head on over to the Kickstarter. Lots of fantastic... Could it be? Could it be? as... there is the Kickstarter right there. There's all sorts of lore and art and things shared. There you go, Anthonym. Thank you. There's the link in chat. Please head on over and give it a look. It's a fantastic level 1 to 13 character story path. And it is a really coolly written... I've been given some sneak peeks to create the one-shot tomorrow. It's going to be an entirely original one-shot written by myself. Slightly nervous. But we have a fantastic group of adventurers who are going to be playing through it as we are joined by Dead Aussie Gamer, Dreaded GM, AJ Winters, and Kendall from One For All. And we... I just saw Chuck from Trolllord Games is in our group message, and they're just posting their characters that they've built. And I just saw a quick message before. It's like, these are all looking amazing, so I can't wait to have a look at them myself.
That'll be so much fun.
So yes, please join us tomorrow if you're able. It's going to be a fantastic one-shot. That is going to be... let me get the timing right... 7 a.m. Eastern, a little earlier than we usually play. It's going to be 2 hours earlier than our usual games. So that is 7 a.m. Eastern, which is going to be 7 p.m. Australian Western, or
8 p.m. Japan time.
8 p.m. in Japan, 9 p.m. Australian Eastern. And if you are able, please do come and join us for that. It's going to be awesome. Then on Saturday we have Candlekeep Mysteries, which brings us round into next week with Rime of the Frost Maiden and back to the Underdark for Out of the Abyss and back here to Barovia and our froggy
There's a neat little function on the clock called World Clock, and you can just have other places' clocks on. So just put you just put a Japan clock on there and always be following what time it is in Japan.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. 9 p.m. Anthony. Excellent, excellent. So you're over. You're in Dreaded GM's time zone then. Fantastic. We hope to see you there. Okay, they're a ridiculously talented group of people, and I cannot wait to play with them. It's our first time playing with Kendall, so I'm very looking forward to that. But yeah, and it's been a long time. It was since the summer campaign of last year that we had AJ on the channel. So AJ Winters is a fabulous player as well. And yeah, Dread and Dag are just, they're fantastic selves as always. And I cannot wait to play with them. All right, everybody. I hope you can get up, Phantom. A little early in the morning. Come on, 6 a.m. That's a line for me. Okay. All right. So that is all for today, my friends. Let us close up these entries and see who the lucky winner is of this Trolllord Games giveaway. Yeah, good luck, everyone. Okay, tonight's copy is going to... And if you are unlucky, join us in Prismia tomorrow or in Candlekeep on Saturday. And, of course, hey, speaking of Trolllord Games, there they are. Speaking of these giveaways, the one-shot tomorrow has some fantastic giveaways. Hard copies of the fantastic books from Trolllord Games, including a grand prize of a signed copy of the adventure once it releases. So everyone, please do jump on that, and we shall see you all for that fantastic, fantastic thing. Okay, so tonight's gift going to... Lee!
Oh, hey. God, yay!
Now, everyone, I just want to point out, It's not because she gifted inspiration.
I think you just tested to make sure next time. Okay.
Wait, did she give inspiration to Phoenix?
No,
or us?
No, it was to Esmeralda.
Okay, good.
Yes, Lee, it's
then
yours.
She deserves it. She deserves it. Then.
Yes, hi, Lee. Welcome. I'm glad that's going to a good person that will definitely put it to good use. Congratulations indeed. So everyone, thank you. Thank you, Trollo Games. There is the Kickstarter link over there. As we shared before, please do jump in there, give them a backing, and you can enjoy the fantastic world that we shall be peeking into. Spoiler free. Do not worry, I will not spoil the adventure for those who wish to play it for themselves. We will just be having a glimpse of the world and playing through my original one shot for that. Okay, so that's all for today, folks. Thank you so, so much. And we shall see you all again very, very soon, my friends, with our giant frog friend here.
Ribbit.
I'm so glad that came. Esmeralda, on a natural 20, the enemy is polymorphed. So there's going to be shenanigans.
I love
down
this
there
so much.
I know it's going to be so good.
Oh my god,
I kind of wish I kind of wish Bjorn, you'd rolled several, so like you're bouncing between different forms.
Well, that'd be neat.
Someday.
Oh my god, I'm so excited.
Thank you everyone, thanks for sharing the love.
If I roll a nat 20 and then you have cleave on, do I just make like a stream of polymorphs as I just do like an ocean of goblins?
That would be amazing. Okay, folks, let's see who's online. Any of the stream team? None of the stream team are on at the moment. Vicky is... she received our raids last time and is doing quite well for herself today. Our friends over at Warlocks and Waffles are on. Let us head over. Those are an entertaining couple of fellas. Let us head on over there and see how they're doing. So, thank you everyone for joining us as always, and stick around for that raid. Get yourself Dream Pie so you can annoy me by giving inspiration to the players next time. Or a disadvantage to me, Thamio, thank you. I'll enjoy using my inspiration crystal in the future. So, that's all for today, folks. Thank you so much. We'll see you all again very, very soon. But stick around for the raid. If you've got them, let those phoenixes fly. Until next time, as we say around these parts, Oyasuminasai.
Oyasuminasai! Sleep tight.
Through murder, through treachery, he rose. You trusted him. All wished his demise. Reckless and cruel, loved through hate. Coburg the Undying, High Lord of Alfstra. He longed for more, for power, for love. But she was gone, taken from him. But he would have it all, power and his love, and the world his yoke, and his war. The road to hell begins with the first step.
The Undying War, a 5th edition adventure path for 1st through 13th level characters that brings an evolving storyline to your table, pulling your adventures into an epic tale. They will journey over land, through dungeons, towns, castles, and even to other planes of existence. With countless NPCs and endless hours of play, immerse yourself and your players in the world of Vaird and Coburg's Undying War. Your journey begins in the simple town of Botkenberg and ends before the gates of hell, from monsters more mundane to beasts of legend. The Undying War, live on Kickstarter. Pledge today and join us at the table.
Trollord Games, join the fray.